I have a very important announcement. To celebrate the 100th year anniversary of discovering the tomb of the boy king Tutankhamun, as a part of this celebration, Egypt is sending 150 masterpieces to tour all over the world. This is 3 times the number of the pieces or the objects that was allowed to travel at one time. 60 of those pieces, they're gonna be the first time that you're gonna see all of them together outside of Egypt. And please, see them, visit them before they turn back to Egypt forever.
I'm Ben Jorgensen from Scholastic News Kids Press Corps, and I'm here with Dr. Perlov, who's a senior vice president here at the California Science Center. So evidence suggests that King Tut was a mediocre king who ruled from a very young age. What do you think about him captured the world's imagination?
Well, the only thing that really made King Tut famous was the discovery of his tomb in 1922, because previously nearly all of the royal tombs were plundered, but Howard Carter found this tomb, and it was resplendent in more than 5,000 beautiful burial objects. And that just made King Tut an overnight celebrity.
Was there any damage to his tomb when it was found?
No, the tomb was really well preserved, and Howard Carter, to his credit in the 1920s, took great care to document and preserve all of the objects, and that's really one of the reasons why they're in such good shape today.
How has modern technology changed this museum from what it was in the 70s?
Well, that's a really good question, because we've used modern technology like big AV projections to show you what these artifacts look like more in depth. You can look behind them. A lot of these burial objects were nested in other burial objects, and it's hard to kind of tell that when you're just seeing one object. So for instance, you see a model of the mummy, and through the video you can see how it was nested in one sarcophagus and then another sarcophagus and another sarcophagus and then in a shrine and a shrine and a shrine. And the same with a number of other objects. You see how they were nested within each other, and the videos that we show can reveal that for the visitors.
Has DNA analysis and CT scans helped you determine more about King Tut's life?
Yes, absolutely. Through CT scans, we're able to determine that he had a club foot, that he had a very bad leg injury that could have caused his death. Through DNA scans, we've determined that he is the son of Akhenaten, the previous pharaoh, and that he had recurring malaria, which could have led to his premature death. And we've also determined that the hole in the back of his head was not caused by a blow to the head, but was caused during the mummification process. So it again puts into question how he died.